Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome again to the next conference this afternoon. With us, we have live all the way from Italy, from Teatro Botlage, Pino Di Budo, who is the director, artistic director, as well as the director of Teatro Botlage. And we have with us Natalia Menta, who is from Switzerland, but who is right now in Italy at Teatro Botlage, and she is an actor and singer. Welcome, both of you, and thank you very much for having accepted our invitation to be here with us. Yes. So, the first question I have, Teatro Botlage is an amazing space. I have always loved to be there, enjoyed every single moment being there. It's a more than 30-year-old theater company. How did this idea come to your mind to make a company with artists from different nationality? It's like, you know, potlatch is really a potlatch, potluck.
Good morning to everybody. I'm very happy to have this meeting with Chintan, with Fanatica, with India, that we love so much. Yeah. To come to us. Teatro Botlage was founded by me and Daniele Regnoli in 1976. Immediately after that, Natalia Menta joined us in 79. And then in the following year, the group expanded.
Yeah.
Before that, I've been teaching for years at the University La Sapienza in Rome as a professor in anthropology and popular tradition.
Yeah.
At the same time, I had a great passion for theater. I had seen in that period wonderful performance, Antigone by Living Theater, La Classe Morta by Tadeusz Kantor, Apocalypse Configuris by Jerzy Grotowski, all of which radically influenced my way of looking at the theater.
Yes.
In that period, I went to Poland to meet Jerzy Grotowski. And I had a long talk with his literary advisor, Ludwig Flaschen, for 2 days.
Wow.
Then I saw Odin Theater in a performance Nifarsius, The House of the Father.
Yeah.
Then I saw Odin Theater's performance, other Odin Theater performance. This performance I saw in the University of Rome. Mm-hmm. And in that occasion, I meet Eugenio Barba, who invited me for a long stay in Denmark. Mm-hmm. But I say immediately, okay. I went with Daniela for 8 months in Denmark.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I had the idea of creation. At the company.
Yeah.
I come back to Italy. I look for a village close to Rome which might have space available. Mm-hmm. And I found Parasabina.
Mm.
That's all.
Wow. Lovely. Great.
Natalie, you have something to say?
Yes. I can say that I present myself and I say hello to all our friends of Fanatica and also all the people that we know in India. I'm Switzerland, like Chintan said before, and I was born from a family of Geneva theatrical environment of the 60s. And I was trained as an artist in Switzerland at the Clown Dimitri School and at the Geneva Academy of Dramatic Art. And in the 1976, I saw a performance of Odin Theater. Come and the day will be ours. With actors from different nationalities. And I realized after this performance that that was the kind of theater that I want to do. And so in 1979, I was about to participate in a workshop at Odin Theater. But Eugenio Barba told me that Odin was not accepting students in this period. Yeah. But he told me that in Italy, in Farasabina, there was a small group called Teatro Potlatch that was looking for actors.
Yeah.
So I decided to follow his advice.
Yeah.
And this, when I arrived in Farasabina, together with Pino Di Buduo and Daniela Regnoli and other four young students, there was also Iben Nigel Rasmussen, the actress that I saw 3 years before in the performance that I saw of Odin Theater.
Yes.
And she was there in Farasabina, in this little village in Rome.
Yes.
It was crazy. And she was leading the training workshop for the new actors.
Yeah.
And so I took this coincidence as a sign of destiny. And that's how I arrived at Teatro Potlatch.
Yeah.
And also in the following years.
Yeah.
It's been often during our tournée abroad, through our performance and our workshop, that we met the actors who eventually joined Teatro Potlatch.
Yeah.
For example, during a tour in Argentina, we met Hector Gustavo Riondet, the actor and director and now scenographer who participates with Pino to the construction of Invisible City in Farasabina.
Yes.
During the tour in Brazil, we found Marcus Atawan.
Yes.
And while Zsófia Guliás, Hungarian, was studying Italy at this time, and she had come in Farasabino for a Sunday trip on this little village, and she discovered Teatro Potlatch and decided to stay there.
Wow!
This as well as many others.
Yes.
Actors.
True. So many people from different countries have gathered there, and because there are so many nationalities, you already are Italians, Swiss, Hungarian, Argentinian, Mexican, but you have also had collaborations with Spanish and other nationalities, Danish people. What are the advantages and difficulties of working in a company full of artists with different nationalities? There is good things about it and bad things. I mean, advantages and difficulties. What do you think?
Being in an international group means that.
Yes.
After a few years, you get to organize Teatro Potlatch tours and projects in a more widespread manner in the foreign actor native country.
Yeah.
This happened with Nathalie in Switzerland, in Brazil, in Argentina, and now in Hungary, with Zsófia.
Yes.
Moreover, it is interesting to observe how, from an actor perspective, the same kind of education, the same kind of training, might be able to express such different personality and artistic expression.
Yes.
I mean this, that the base is the same, but then when you arrive in the performance to the creative space, each personality come out with his own culture. Mm-hmm. Therefore, is a valuable improvement for the group. It's mm-hmm. very important mm-hmm. because on the beginning, you had to find a way to go together.
Yeah.
But after some, this became very helpful for each one of us.
Yeah.
The downside thought is that you can not think as a performance based in a theatrical text to be performed only in Italian. Mm-hmm. We could not think that we could make a performance on Italian text.
Yeah.
Because a different language you could feel.
Yes.
But this has been helpful for us because this helped us to go to abroad
yes.
and be interesting also for other culture, for other countries.
Yeah. So what are the languages in which you perform? Italian, Portuguese, Spanish?
Portuguese, Spanish, French, English.
English, so many languages.
Also, Daniela, we made also Brecht in German and Italian.
Oh, how lovely.
Yes. The most of the actors speak German.
Okay.
Daniela is half Italian, half German.
Okay.
Natalie studied in the school in Switzerland, German.
Yeah.
The other learn.
Yeah.
They didn't learn at the first the language in general. They learn the language only for the performance.
Yes.
And who could hear the performance thought that they could know the language very well, but it was not true.
Like,
because we practiced a lot on the language.
Like molto rumore per nulla, most Indian people did in Italian.
Yes, yes, like that.
Fantastic. Like
that. Yes, yes.
This was fantastic because you feel, you see that it's from another culture and you enjoy very much to true. Hear people from other countries speak your language.
Yes.
Yes.
True. Natalie, would you like to add about this? What is your experience, advantages,
yes.
difficulties of working yes. in a company with so many nationalities?
Yes. So for me, the first years in Farah Sabina, the difficulties that I encountered in the work was the behavioral collisions mm-hmm. between the Italian culture
yeah.
and the Swiss culture.
Okay. Yes. For example?
Yeah. For example, for me, that during the performance that people speak together, but what do you say? No, I think there is like that. No, what this rhythm of speaking was not like that in my country. So
yeah.
I think, oh my God, what's happened? And after this, continue the work very tranquilly, very quiet. And so for me, I saw this expression of speaking of Italian
yeah.
that after time helped me also to live out also my expression in this way.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes, yes, yes.
And so I begin to put together Swiss, that I am from Swiss, and also something that I was shocked on the beginning, but after not. This was one point I thought.
Yes.
That another thing, because I was one stranger, but after there was a Brazilian, other people, and for us, stranger, in this group in Italia, what helped us to channeling our energy during the first years of education was the program of study and of research of the actor. What we are doing there.
Yeah.
And also the behavioral rules we had to observe inside and outside of the theater, which Teatro Potluck supervisors themselves establishes. And the third thing is, there is a reason why I became also an organizer. Why?
Right.
Because first was to be connected by with my family and my whole language, and so French.
Yes.
The second is because 40 years ago, the social context of the territory of Parasabina was very different.
Of course,
and so in, you can imagine, in this time I learned to make ravioli, I learned to know how you make olive oil, that parpon that I like.
Yes.
But in this time I couldn't speak with the people who were around in this little village because I don't find a connection. Now it's very different.
Yeah.
And for this necessity to speak with a person who make theater, for to communicate with other people in the field of theater, I began to speak as an organizer and to speak for Potlatch, to propose a performance or workshop. And after 15 years, when I can propose the Invisible Cities project.
Yeah.
But this communication for me was very important because it make me feel involved in the theatrical time of the past and be part of them.
Okay.
This is for me.
Yeah, lovely, lovely. It's so interesting that, you know, how an actor tries to do local activities like making olive oil or making ravioli in order to learn the local culture and learn the language, be part with them, interact with them. How lovely. Yes. Pino, you wanted to add something? Yes.
Yes, just a little thing. This experiment that we made inside our group with the time had a strong influence on the people of the little village where we live in Farasabina.
Yes.
On the beginning, they were scared about stranger people. Now they are so open, not only with us, but also with the people from other part of the world that we invite.
True.
They are very permissive. They are very open to different culture.
Yes.
And this is maybe is the most important result that Potlatch had in this place.
True. So it's with one theater, the entire village also transforms because such a small place becomes such an international spot with all the people coming from everywhere in the world. Yes.
Esatto. Esatto. Yeah.
So the next question is, what is, according to you, your best artistic invention, which will be your legacy to the generations to come? And how did you invent it?
This is a very important point. Necessity is the mother of the invention.
Yes.
I think my legacy. Is the way that we look at the space around us. And it expresses in a project this way of looking, expressing a project that was born out of a profound necessity. In 1991, came out this project that is called Invisible Cities. Which was the necessity. It was over than 10 years that Teatro Potlatch was established in Fara Sabina. Yes. We were presenting our experimental performance, and they were extremely successful in international festival. Mm. But the inhabitants of Fara Sabina and of the surrounding area had little interest in them.
Yeah.
We were organizing festival with performance by extraordinary artists from different corners of the world, with a great success among the critic, but a little audience.
Yes.
We wanted that the inhabitants of Fara Sabina and of the surrounding to get to know us more closely. Mm. So we invite them to participate with their association. Mm. Choir, vernacular theater, group, folk dance, group traditional music bands.
Yes.
In a project together with us in the street, in the square, in the courtyard, in the garden, in the cellar, and even inside the house of Fara Sabina, connecting their work and our work to the Middle Age architecture of the historical
city.
Yes. Along to the architecture began to have a central meaning, because we start our idea from the memory of the space around us, of the house, of the architecture.
Yes.
This architecture we transformed meter after meter with the light, huge white transparent clothes with the projection. Mm-hmm. This project is called Invisible Cities. So the team is invisible. Its first staging was in 1991, in the historical center of Fara Sabina. It was attended by an audience of 2,000 people. All the inhabitants came to see.
Wow.
All the surrounding people came to see, because they came to see their own association, their own choice, their own form of dance.
Yes.
That was the expression that belongs to them. But through this, they began to know better our way of looking at the future.
True. Lovely. And that is one of the best artistic inventions that I have come across in my life.
Oh, thank you.
Yes. Yes, Natalie.
Yes, Chintan, just a little thing, because I thought to the legacy of Pino. What is the legacy that Pino leave to the new generation? And I think about this, and I would just add that for the people who had the chance to work with Pino as a director, his ability to make an actor grow. He knows how to transform an actor's body and his work into quality. He knows how to transform a space. Mm. And he knows how to identify an actor's hidden identity inside as a creative source. Mm. And he knows how to guide the actors in the conquest of the space. Could be an actor, a dancer, an opera singer, a visual artist. This is, I think, another part of the legacy of Pino di Budo.
Yes, lovely, true. So the next question is, you are primarily focused on physical theater and the visuals. What importance do you give to the text and how do you explore it?
Ma the proposal comes from the actor. This is the main thing. I give it some inspiration, some time, but each actor have to bring his own proposition in relation to the theme that we choose. Then little by little become a dialogue between me and the actor, between me and the work of the actor. We began to develop this process until take a structure that is in relation to the theme that we choose to experiment, to explore. Why this? Because if the actor make a proposition, belongs to him, to her.
Yes.
So has another meaning, express more the his identity, his point of view of the life, but his sensibility, his artistic sensibility.
Yes.
For me, it's fantastic because I react not to only my my feeling, my opinion, my thinking, but to something that is around me. And so I began to build, reacting to this material, and I give an orientation to this material until the performance is finished. I think this is this for me is a collective process. In the end, the result. I am not a director, like traditional director, that I ask the actor what to do. No. I am somebody that is able to work with and create together. Also, of course, in the last moment, in the last period, in the last phase of the process, I am director.
Yeah.
In that moment, I give the final view of the performance.
Yeah. Okay. Natalie, what would you like to say here?
Just a little thing about the text. When we begin to work with a spoken text, we explore with Pino and with the other actors, often with the rhythm, the pause, the moments where it's become more quickly, the actions. And sometimes Pino suggests how a sentence should be spoken, which kind of musicality an actor should apply to it. And in a certain way, he helped us with the motivation, giving a motivation to the actor to bring out our own way to say this word. This is the work on the text. And little by little, the actor find their own way to work with the text, real text.
What is the importance of organizing flipped? What is your vision behind it?
The festival, the flipped intercultural workshop festival of theatrical practice, is an important training school for actors whose research is graduated on their home body.
Yes.
Excellent pedagogue from Eastern and Western theater allows to participate, allows the participant to experience directly on their body the different form of different theatrical culture. This is important, that they are in confront in a short time to in practice, they have a practical experience on their body, so they see what mean different culture, intercultural. Mm-hmm. It's a festival, it's also the most of all a place where young theater enthusiastic who come from different parts of the world and are starting to build their own artistic identity through the exchange.
Yes.
They can meet each other. Yes. It's fundamental. Yes. They are not alone. Yes. They can build, but not build only with their country, with their friends in the local city, but with the a point of view much more open, large, and in international confrontation that for us give more quality, help more quality to the work.
Yes.
This is the main function of the festival.
Yeah.
It's not... It's also the place where, like in every festival, you can see many international performances. Yes. But what makes the flip unique is that the members of the international company are most of the time invited to stay for the whole duration.
Yes.
And the participants in participate in the different events and which are especially created by the festival.
Yes.
So become a very international, intercultural creation.
True.
The basic idea and understand the festival is anyway interculturality. This is behind every conception.
So the next question I wanted to ask is, how do you manage to finance your company? What tips can you give to the young and struggling companies?
The main, to have a group theater means to create an economy beside the work.
Yes.
The potlatch is mainly financed through the selling of the performances.
Yes.
But not only the performance. Many activity behind the performance become an important economy. Many form of organization of a festival, workshop, tours abroad, which over time grows more and more important.
Mm.
Around the 30-40% is depending, depending by the year, come from the support of the Italian Ministry of Culture, Foreign Office, and from support of our region, and from the municipality. Also in the last 2 or 3 years, the support of a foundation of a bank of our area is beginning important.
Yes.
The national and the European invitation to tender are becoming more and more important also.
Yes.
It's changing. From our beginning, it's very changing this.
Yes.
On the beginning, 60% of our cost began from our ministry,
yes,
our institution. Now is the opposite.
Yeah.
If I have to advise young people to create, is try to create, to acquire technique, to study. This is fundamental.
Yeah.
To study doesn't mean to study book only.
Yeah.
It's to study with your body, with your voice, with your imagination, with your behavior. To learn high technique of behavior in relation to how to build in a group, for example. I have an advice for young people. I think that is important to create, that they create an education that allows technical acquisition not only connected with the art of the actor.
Mm.
The main thing is the art of the actor. Mm. So they, I think they have to acquire technique for the body, for the voice, for the process of creativity, for the how to compose a performance, how to work on the space. This is very, very important.
Yes.
But not only, because today to be autonomous need to acquire technique in different different island around the performance.
Yeah.
But they have to expand on the satellite field that can help provide their economical survival.
Yes.
And then, anyway, the invention will be the center of their future.
Their future. So true. So true. Very well.
The invention is fundamental, is the center.
Yes. Natalie, what do you have to say about it?
So for me, it was important because I come in Italy for theater, for this kind of theater, and I learned to be also an organizer.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm curious, and so I like also the territory in around where we are, the field, the how the cultivation, I like olive trees of olive. I was curious to learn how they make olive oil.
Yeah.
But now, if you think now, also theater can go also in the field of olive and trees. There is a transversal meeting that we can build with theater and with our territory. We are a territory in Italy made of olive and trees.
Yes.
This is one example.
Yeah.
But the same thing that Pino said before in the term of technical.
Yeah.
Different kind of technique, but also learn, I can say to the people, to the young people, learn what is your territory, what are the resource of their territory. This is an example.
That is very important. It's so good. That question, next question I have is, theater and technology. You have combined and explored the two together. Tell us about the best, the worst, and the funniest experiences.
Only Chintan can make this kind of question. For many years, we explore the art of the actor.
Yeah.
Then, time after time, we put the work of the actor in relation with other discipline.
Yes.
First was anthropology, then sociology, then architecture. 20 years ago, within our theater, we started a study of the high technology in the field of image sound.
Yes.
It took a lot of time to explore this file.
Yeah.
And cost very much.
Yeah.
And many attempts failed.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
But we didn't give up.
Yeah.
And we put a lot of money and time on this project.
Yeah.
Only in the last past few years, this investment started to yield and give birth to new language, a new world to explore, and a good economy.
Yes, so true. What is the name of that machine, that projector? How do you call it in Italian?
In Italian, we call it video projector. Mm-hmm. With this video projector, we started first to work inside the theater on the
screen,
the interior.
Yes.
But then we start also outside to project on the face of the building, on the trees, on the floor, on. We develop a lot. We study. We make a lot of experiment, tentativi.
Yes.
But we doesn't work. We know how to work with the video mapping.
Yeah.
But it's not a work of video mapping, because our intention is to make see for the first time what is the environment.
Yeah.
That in, one of us see in the everyday life, because the everyday life make you blind, and to see again the value of what is around you, what you see from your window, what you see when you come out from your house, when you go walking in the street to your work. this you had to hide, you had to transform in the moments that you hide, in the moments that you transform, you see for the first time, and you give again value. To give value means that you began to tell about again and again to your friends, to the people that you meet. And this gives you the energy creative that is fundamental for the life.
Yes, so true. Natalie?
For me, one thing in this question that you is that I like exploring. I like exploring new theatrical materials, like, for example, the fog machine.
Yeah.
Or new equipment like the tightrope.
Yes.
Or new theatrical costumes which were never used before. And with this kind of material, discovering their ability to convey emotion. I spend a lot of time in this exploration, looking for poetry, the synthesis between me, this new relation, and the surrounding space. In the past few years, I developed a passion for the new technology, especially working with the fog, a text and the geometrical projections that transform the space. And then also, I with a very good passion with the gigantic projection of waterfalls in the 70 meter by 35 meter of scenography that Pino creates on the main square of Farasabina, that you know, for Invisible.
Yes.
And I ask me, how can I become one with the digital scenography?
Yes.
How I can perceive them and see myself through different eyes. Mm. For me, it's like working with the wind. This I can say.
This is beautiful, and we are going to show to our audiences some images from invisible cities, so they get an idea about what is it that we are talking about here, where Nathalie is in this square of Farasabina, 75 meters by 35 meters. It's a mind-boggling visual. Very good.
Sure.
The last question for this conference I have for you is, what do you look for when you travel, and how do other cultures influence your work?
I really love to travel through my job.
Yeah.
It was a fundamental goal when I decided to found a theater.
Yeah.
But to travel with your own job needs strong motivation and great ability to adapt.
Yes.
At the same time, the real driving force is the curiosity. Mm. That unique energy that costs nothing, that pushes you to go further, to widen your own field of knowledge, to meet people, custom and tradition, to encounter a new form of life, a new way of understanding art, and get enriched.
Yes.
The deep encounter of the anthropological and human study of different culture and men is a great enrichment. Mm. And for me is an imparagonabile creative nourishment.
Yes.
This give the south of my imagination, okay, of my maintain young the creativity.
Yes.
Because all the time is stimulating new form.
True.
For example, for me it was something extraordinary. Mm. When you drive us in the central historic center of Ahmedabad.
Yes.
I could imagine it would be so amazing, so fantastic, mm. and so concrete to see the life inside. And the second for my imagination was the temple of the water.
Mm.
Was the little first was the little room with all small a thousand million of small specchi
mirrors
painted that create a fantastic world. A fantasy is amazing. And then to go down in a large, incredible steps under the water.
Yes.
To build a temple around the source of water is something that gave me something extraordinary. When I drink some water, has another meaning from that moment.
Yes, true.
Thank you, Chintan, to make me see this golden shining diamond.
Mi piacere. It was my pleasure. Yes, Nathalie.
For me, I have to say that in all the country I traveled, in all the theatrical cultures I encountered, I always found something that belonged to me. Uh-huh. And that allowed me to communicate with them. Mm. And this encounter deeply influenced my work and continually influence my work also now.
Yeah.
For example, in the moment where you are alone, where you say, oh no, it's not possible, all this thinking that everyone has, and when you don't find the solution of things, also me, I think of the first time in 2013 where you show me the center of Ahmedabad. For me, it's really a certain courtyard beside a temple that for me here it's heaven. Like a pellegrinaggio.
Yes, a pilgrimage. Yes.
And also the statue of the poet, all the construction of the center, historical center. This is really incredible. So I remember what image come from this travel and the people that and where we are doing in this moment and. All these things are really important to create to artist in the way of the artist. Also, the visit of the fort, of the big fort. I don't know fortress.
Fort.
This incredible, different kind of level of architecture. And how now it is extraordinary.
Yeah.
And this is always in my mind to make maybe, I hope, an invisible cities project some part in Ahmedabad or I don't know, somewhere.
I keep my fingers crossed for it. Yes. We do that for sure. Well, thank you so very much, both of you. Thank you for being here.